Claire had a dramatic episode, as she saved the life of a man and proved women can be just as good as, if not better than, men. Here are Claire's top moments from Outlander Season 4, Episode 8. Life isn't quiet for Claire Beecham Randall Fraser, is it? Even a night at the theater turns into a dramatic event. That was certainly the case for her in Outlander Season 4, Episode 8. When Jamie needed a diversion, Claire was able to create it. That diversion did become something she needed to do anyway by saving a man's life. For those who aren't aware, this scene was taken from the books but in another point in the story and with a different character. It's probably one of the timeline changes Ron D. Moore was talking about when discussing events in the book. I'll share more about those changes later this week. For now, it's time to look at the best Claire moments in the episode. 3. Fangirling over George Washington. I do love how Diana Gabaldon's novels have included real people from history. Governor Tryon is one of them for Outlander Season 4, but possibly one of the most important turned up last night. We got to meet Colonel George Washington. Yes, the first President of the United States. Getting the chance to see Claire sort of fangirl over him was sweet. No other person in history has made her do this, but this is the man who will make the colonies into America. He's the man who will become the first president. As she says, Brianna would have 100 questions. Claire clearly would have too, although she needs to be careful with slipping up on facts she shouldn't know just yet. 2. Creating the diversion for Jamie. There have been plenty of times that Claire had tried to argue against something Jamie has done. While in the theater, Jamie realized that Mr. Fanning needed help and it was just the diversion he needed to get to Myrtle. Claire didn't argue with Jamie at all. Of course, there wasn't time. Jamie had to rush to warn Myrtle and there was a patient on the brink of death in need of Claire's surgical skills. She jumped straight into doctor mode, but I love that she also supported Jamie at the same time. You get the feeling that the surgery lasted a little longer than it needed to, especially when it came to the stitches. She took her time with each one, clearly waiting for a glimpse of her husband returning. After all, if she stopped and Jamie wasn't around, there would have been plenty of questions about where he was. And while creating the diversion, she managed to gain respect from the people in the theater. They had the chance to see her skill at surgery and at saving lives. As Governor Tryon said, it's no wonder Jamie says he couldn't live without her. Really, it's not the surgical skills. It's the unselfish support she showed him during this episode. 1. The moment with Marsley. At the beginning of the episode, we had the chance to see Claire and Jamie as doting grandparents. It's absolutely adorable, but most importantly, it led to another sweet moment between Claire and Marsley. I love how the two have grown closer over the season. When they first met in Outlander Season 3, there were all sorts of understandable tension. Neither liked each other, but they've come to see that neither are threats and neither are the evil women they've initially believed. The moment in the kitchen is full of pride and comfort. Marsley is bursting with emotion, experiencing the unconditional love of being a mother. Claire is able to share in that, without completely giving it away that there's a secret she's been hiding from everyone. One thing I'm going to enjoy about Brianna showing up is how everyone else will react. This is time for Fergus to find out he has a sister. He may be unofficially on paper adopted, but I view him as Claire and Jamie's son because that's how they're treating him, and Marsley realizes that Claire does know what it's like being a mother. Whatever happens, it's certainly not going to take away from this moment in the kitchen as the two women connect further and create another bond.